to us than this one here. So again, it's this theme of trade-offs. Now this here is Mather Dining.
Yeah, so fun fact, I took this photo here myself on my phone.
In Mather Dining Hall?
Mather Dining Hall, one of the undergrad dining halls, one of the undergraduate dormitories that has a dining hall, because I wanted a picture of some familiar trays that are stacked up so as to give a visual for what would otherwise be literally an abstract data type on which, with which we begin to solve slightly more interesting problems at this point, with a fancier data structure.
And that's a really careful distinction you've made between a data structure and an abstract data type. Mm-hmm. You know, I myself am guilty of referring to stacks and queues as data structures. But they really are, they are abstract because, as we spoke about a little bit earlier in the Explain series, there's multiple ways to implement a stack or a queue. It's a representation of something you can do as opposed to a fixed concept like an array.
And this is why I like them, because we have an opportunity to discuss how you can implement them in different ways, either with an array or maybe a linked list or maybe even in some other way. But the point is that it doesn't matter. This is now a black box for all we're concerned, much like functions that we do discuss earlier in the semester. And it's an opportunity to think about how you can provide a uniform interface or an API, the simplest of APIs, pushing and poppy or queuing and queuing, queuing and dequeuing, and not have the user worry about how that's implemented underneath the hood. Of course, if you go with certain design decisions like an array, you might actually then hit some real limitations, like it might be fixed size unless you actually go through the trouble of reallocating it and resizing it as needed by reallocating the memory. But it's a good opportunity, I think, to keep building and building with each progressive week on what we're doing. And it's all the better if we have,
It's certainly nice that a dining hall or cafeteria gives us the opportunity to present both
gives
of these.
Gives is a little generous.
Well, it does, because you have you can build stacks and represent the concept
they
of a stack with the
so
trays.
They just have so many.
They do. But you can also represent queues by virtue of having, in particular, in more of a cafeteria style than a dining hall, where you're a little more free-flowing, a line of people. The first person who's in line
Very
is the first
true.
Person who's going to get food, and the last person in line is going to be the last person to get their food.
Very true. Supposedly, I don't know if it's myth, because I never did this myself, but supposedly freshmen at Harvard will take those same kind of dining hall trays when it snows outside, go into Harvard Yard, where Widener Library is, with the really big concrete steps, and when there's enough snow on them, use the trays as sleds.
No comment.
Doug Lloyd, did you really?
No comment.
Interesting. Well, abstract data types.